right, so we've initiated the 10K program and we've loaded the sickle cell module. So when we first start, if you look at your hands, you'll see both controllers are visible, both the right and the left hand controllers. And they may look a little different if you're using a Vive, but I'm using an Oculus Rift for this recording. So what we're gonna wanna do first is get rid of this left hand controller by initiating demo mode. And so to do this, we want to use the B button on the right controller or whichever button has these three lines on it in your visualized controller. So press that, you'll see the name of the module and logos, and we want to point at demo mode and trigger it with the right index finger trigger. And then we want to resume. Don't quit, that will quit everything. We want to resume the program. Great, so now if you look down again, you'll only have one controller visible in front of you. Now the next step after we get rid of our left-hand controller by entering demo mode is to enable a feature that makes it a lot easier for viewers to watch what someone is doing while they're in the headset. So we have an option, I'm going to put down the controller, to hold down the S button on your computer keyboard. And if you look at the screen of the laptop, or if you're hooked up to an additional screen, it should zoom out and show a much wider field of view, and it'll also slow down the tracking. So if you move your head around, it's a lot slower than what you're actually seeing through the headset, so people who are watching don't get whiplash or get sick while trying to watch. So now that we've got everything set up, it's time to dive into the module. In front of you, you'll see a human body, which is a simulation of someone with sickle cell disease. And you'll notice that if you point at the body with the laser with your right hand controller, you'll see a label come up. Same goes for their chart. So this is like their hospital chart tracking how they're feeling. So you'll notice that if you point at an object, it shows the label. And if you want to expand that label to learn more about the object, you press your right index finger trigger. So that will expand a description and give you a little bit more information about whatever you're pointing at. So feel free to do that whenever you want to learn more. And if you want to collapse or close that expanded label, you just press that right trigger once again. You can also collapse it by moving the laser far away. So let's dive in. You'll notice in the human body label, there's a little arrow next to it. And this means that we can go deeper into that object by zooming in and going to a higher magnification. So if you want to zoom into something, you just hold the joystick on your right hand forward or up very gently and then release. All right, so now we've landed on a bone. So we're about 1000x magnified. And we're standing on the surface of the bone, and you can see that it's vascularized. So there's blood vessels attached to it that let blood flow in and out. And in sickle cell patients, most of the problems are visible in the blood vessels. So let's go into a vessel by pointing at one and pressing up on the joystick to zoom in. All right, so we're now inside the vessel or capillary. And we can see on the left side, before this vessel splits two ways, there's pretty good blood flow. There's all these red blood cells moving down pretty quickly. And on the right side, you can see all these sickle-shaped cells are clogging and getting caught. And this is blocking blood flow to that area. And this is what happens in real sickle patients. Their blood cells are misshapen, and so they get stuck, and other cells carrying oxygen are not able to get to tissues and deliver oxygen. So this causes damage to the tissues and a lot of really horrible pain. So this is also a cool environment where you can turn all the way around and see the blood coming from behind you. It's kind of wild to see the cells moving towards you. So now let's look into one of these sickled cells and see what's going on. We can go into this one right in front of us. All right, so here we are inside the sickle-shaped cell. So this is hemoglobin. And hemoglobin is the protein that's in all of your red blood cells that helps carry oxygen through your body. And hemoglobin is really supposed to look like these, where they're kind of free-floating and bopping around happily. But in sickle cell patients, there's this mutation, which you can see right here, these little red dots are mutations in the protein that cause this version of hemoglobin to stick together. And when it sticks together, it ends up forming these long, long fibers that go all the way up and down. You might not want to look down if you get vertigo. So you can see that these fibers are pretty stiff. They're not floating freely. They're kind of stuck together. And this is what causes the shape change in sickle-shaped cells, because the cells can't just be round and flexible. Instead, they get warped into these sickled, stretched out shapes because they're full of these stiff fibers of hemoglobin. Now, this is pretty nasty, so it would be great if we could offer some sort of treatment to this person, and that's what we're going to show you today. And as you see, there's this mutation in the protein, and this all comes from a mutation in the protein's instructions or the genetic code. So if we want to fix this mutation, we have to fix the DNA instructions that contain that error. So to do this, we're going to leave the sickled cells. So you're going to want to hold down on your controller to zoom back out. And then let's go out one more time, because we want to go to the bone marrow. And bone marrow is inside your bones. So let's zoom into the bone and look around. So we're now in the bone marrow, and this is where all of your blood stem cells live. So those are these whitish, purplish cells. And these are the cells that are responsible for dividing to make all of your new red blood cells. If we can fix the DNA in these cells, we can keep all of the red blood cells that come from those stem cells healthy. So let's point at a blood stem cell and zoom in there. All right, so this is the high school biology flashback. You'll see around you things like mitochondria and kinesins that are walking slowly along microtubules. These are the motor proteins that help move things around your cells. All kinds of cool cell biology stuff. In sickle cell disease and gene editing, what we really care about is the DNA, and that's all stored in the nucleus. So that's this big greenish blob right in front of you. So let's go into the nucleus and look at DNA. So here we are in the nucleus. You can see there's all kinds of DNA around you. And right in front of us, we can see the hemoglobin gene. And within that hemoglobin gene, there's this orange mutation. So this is the one typo in all of those letters that's causing sickle cell disease. So if we can fix this, we can hopefully help the patient. So to do this, we've designed a CRISPR molecule to come and cut at exactly this location. So this little teal-colored target sequence is where we've told the CRISPR protein to go by programming its guide RNA. And you'll see that we've already shown the CRISPR protein and donor DNA inside the cell. So this is the Cas9 protein, and this is its guide RNA that we've programmed to go to exactly this location. And then this is the donor DNA that we're going to have the cell paste in over the damaged portion to replace the mutation. Now, to watch this in action, we just point at this cube with a plus inside that says treat with CRISPR, and you use that right index finger trigger to start the animation and the gene editing process. So here we see the Cas9 protein is finding its target, wrapping around the DNA, and making a cut. So you see right there, there's a cut through it. And now the cell is gonna freak out and need to repair this break. So this repair protein has come in, displaced Cas9, and it's pasting in this healthy donor sequence that we added. So by the end of this sequence, you've replaced the mutated DNA with this healthy version. So let's watch that again. You can do this by pointing at this replay icon, pressing the right trigger. So let's see Cas9 coming in, unwinding the DNA, base pairing it with its guide RNA, making a cut right through it, a double strand break. And now the repair protein from the cell that's already in there is going to try to paste in and replace this whole segment that was causing issues. And we kind of don't show you the full process. We have this, you know, white mist that comes over because it would be pretty complicated to show the entire repair process. And we really just want you to know that you can replace pieces of DNA using CRISPR. Great, so we've done it. We've hopefully helped this patient by editing their DNA. We're just showing you one cell, but in theory, we'd want a CRISPR treatment to occur in every one of the cells. So let's zoom back out. So I'm gonna hold the trigger down and go back to the bone marrow. And if I look around, I can already tell that there are no more sickled cells. And again, we're showing you this instant effect. In reality, this would probably take a lot longer, but you get instant gratification in virtual reality. So we have only these nice, healthy looking red blood cells that are nice and round. These can get through blood vessels pretty easily. They're not gonna get clogged. So let's zoom back out. And then let's return to the blood vessel because that's where the traffic jam was happening. So we've made it to the capillary and it looks like that occlusion or blockage that was right here before is now gone. And so we just have these happy cells moving through the vessel. Everything is looking great. So this was a successful gene editing therapy. But let's check inside these cells. So let's zoom into a red blood cell, if we can catch one. And here we are, we can see all the hemoglobin is now free floating and happy. There are no more fibers floating around. We have just the functional hemoglobin bopping around, ready to carry oxygen. So great, so we've fixed the DNA, which fixes the protein, and then fixes the tissue level issues. So now we're back in the blood vessel. Let's zoom back out. And let's go all the way back to the human level. Here we go. So we're back at the 10x big human. And we can see that this patient has had a great outcome. We were able to edit their hemoglobin gene. Their blood cells are looking healthy now. They have normal oxygen levels and their pain is significantly reduced. So we've done it. So again, I just want to reiterate, this is not a treatment that is available yet. It's something that we're working on here at the Innovative Genomics Institute. There are also a lot of other groups working to cure the same disease through slightly different approaches. It's all kind of happening at once. So hopefully this is something that materializes into a real therapy for patients very soon. So if you'd like to try it again or revisit something, you can just point at this little reset patient icon to the right and trigger it with your index finger, and that'll replace that patient with a new one who also needs to be gene edited and is ready for your help. That's the end of the walkthrough. Thanks for your interest in CRISPR VR, and thank you for watching.